Achieving cyber superiority will not just happen. We've got to make a dedicated effort through our exercises and our training to ensure that our communicators can connect our networks, make them interoperable, and keep them resilient. 13 years of operations in Afghanistan have proven that combined endeavor works. We've been able to build the Afghan Mission Network and interoperate with our partners in a combat environment because of the lessons that have come out of combined endeavor. Combined Endeavor is U.S. European Command's premier C4 exercise. It's designed to focus on interoperability and enables us and our allies to exercise our ability to communicate in command and control.
The evolution of Exercise Combined Endeavor is a very interesting read.
We started at 95 with 10 nations, 96 it was 13, and 97, 18, and then, I don't know, it really grew up.
At the beginning we started with simple radio tests, and if we could get a result that we could talk to each other from one nation to another nation, that was an excellent result.
I remember, you know, Slovenia was one of the first time on the exercise in 1995. We were there with a circuit switch, PBX. We still have that, we'll bring that this year.
In the words of a former exercise director, it was "can you hear me now" type testing.
The exercise was a technical focus exercise in the past. Now the exercise is completely different.
We're an alliance and we work with partners that have enjoyed dominance on battlefields because we've made the proper investments in the past in both the communications and cyber domains.
If you cannot connect your systems and be able to share a recognized picture together, you're going to fail every time.
This year, 2014, is the 20th iteration of Exercise Combined Endeavor.
This year we're in Grafenwöhr, Germany, with 1,300 people participating from 30 different nations. Four different countries have come as observers, including two organizations.
So this current exercise is all of the land component forces, or coalition forces, with the lead force being the UK.
And the UK is establishing not just the land component command, including all of the services upwards and downwards to the mission groups, but also Mission Group 2, along with coalition partners.
Welcome to Combined Endeavor 2014. My challenge to this year's Combined Endeavor team is to remember that at the heart of this exercise is building partner capacity for when our adversaries look across the borders of each nation, they should see more than an individual country. They should see a coalition that is not only ready to fight, but is capable and ready to fight now.
So Combined Endeavor is going to give us some important lessons that will inform how we build our future mission network and our mission partner environment.
It is crucial to have the standards the same so that all 28 NATO nations really work to that same standard.
Combined Endeavor exercise allows all nations to check the most recent solution in command and control systems.
JMEIs are joining membership and exiting instructions that we exercise here at Combined Endeavor.
Last year we are starting testing JMEIs, but never really look at how we should exit a coalition network.
This year we are focused on exiting instructions, which will allow nations to gracefully exit the Combined Endeavor mission network.
Our main goal is, of course, to improve JMEIs. JMEIs are very important for each nation to be, let's say, united according to Federation mission networking requirements.
We want to be part of future mission network, FMN concept, so that's why we're learning how to build a network. It's still the telecommunication system, but built according to some future mission network concept.
Combined Endeavor for us enables the kinds of designed and implemented architecture that enables operators to command the fight.
Our operational focus is changing as the security situation in the world is changing.
And the United Kingdom is also using this venue to validate this new force construct.
So we brought onto the ground a real armored infantry brigade headquarters so that we could stress test or operationalize the kind of technical aspects that we've been doing on combined endeavor for the last 20 years.
I think that bringing along the operational staff users is a really important part of showing operational relevance of the network. So what we're really looking at is not just establishing the network, but also how usable it is with our staff users within a brigade headquarters, at brigade main, and down to a brigade forward.
We recognize the fact that no matter what we do, we have a requirement to ensure we have cyber superiority. That is our ability to do the things that we want to do on our networks.
Cyber defense is important because of the foreseeable threat due to the real situation what's happened now in nowadays.
We've also augmented this exercise with additional cyber endeavor series of training that started with a cyber defense seminar.
And the audience here is specifically those information assurance professionals that will be defending their network in combined endeavor and training them on the tools and techniques that our adversarial red team will be using to attack the network.
So the red team construct this year is a little different than in the past. We've got 10 people from 7 different nations. The way it's constructed is they're doing specific missions opposed to just creating noise. There are planned injects, specifically taking down core services at certain times, which is critical.
So for the Ukraine especially, it's really important because of their current situation. So we create a new cyber defense center back home in Ukraine. And here in Combined Endeavor, we train our officers and soldiers to be a part of that cyber defense center.
Without being able to interoperate, without communication, you can do nothing.
I think that's very important that we have one opportunity per year to test our system and to see if we can interconnect together. I think that if we have to find a way to go further and to test together.
It's very hard to overestimate the benefit of combined endeavor in consolidating of CIS community. So we truly are keen to see that the combined endeavor will continue in some form its activities in the future as well.
If we will not have exercises like this, step by step, we can lose this relationship between countries.
Even in a resource-constrained environment, so if we did have something like combined endeavor, we would need something like combined endeavor, because at the end of the day for us, if we're not keeping pace as both allies and partners of the problem sets that we're seeing mount daily in both the cyber and communication domains, then we lose the initiative.
And because the alliance is transitioning from a campaign in Afghanistan to a contingency footing, that makes the ability to plug and play units inside multinational formations even more relevant, more important. So Exercise Combined Endeavor has a direct role in achieving that sort of interoperability of our communication systems.